Hey, Jeff, founder of IntelliHost here, and today I want to give you a demo of our product. If you don't have time to schedule a call, or maybe you just know we're data nerds and we're kind of awkward like that, this video is for you. So you can stop, start, fast forward, whatever you want to do, and get going on the product. If you're a large property manager or you own just a couple properties, we want to make this relevant to you and make sure that this answers all of your main questions. Now, the purpose of creating IntelliHost was actually not originally intended to be a product for anyone else. I'm a property manager, and we manage 14 of our own properties in Florida. We needed better tools to optimize our listings on the OTAs. We needed to know what kind of traffic we were getting and what kind of performance and conversion rates we were seeing on those OTAs. So we actually built IntelliHost as an internal tool originally, and it was a total game changer for us. And so we decided to release this as a product for everyone. There's a few main questions we get from everyone. So I want to hit those questions right off the bat before we dive into the product. Number one, where do we get our data? When you first sign up with IntelliHost, you're going to be asked to set up your Airbnb account with IntelliHost. The reason we do that is because all the data we use in IntelliHost is actually collected from your Airbnb account. The way that works is that you actually invite us to either your team or invite us as a co-host to a specific property. We have instructions on how to do that in the platform. Once we are able to collect that data, we then use our algorithms and calculations to format the data in a way that's helpful for you. We'll see that once you get into the product that we organize this in a funnel format so that you can see the four steps of the booking funnel, or meaning every step that a guest takes before they book your property. That's where the data is coming from. You'll also notice in your dashboard that we have competitive average metrics. These competitive averages are coming straight from Airbnb. Airbnb does not tell us which properties are being selected in that competitive set, but we do know that they are straight from Airbnb, and so they're straight from the horse's mouth. So let's dive in. You'll notice here, the first thing you see are the four steps that every guest takes before they book your property on Airbnb. Now, we are only tracking Airbnb metrics. I know you would love to see VRBO data and booking.com. Unfortunately, as of right now, VRBO and booking.com do not publish relevant metrics for this type of decision making. When they do, we will be happy to integrate that, but as of right now, that is not available in our platform. The good thing is, these are the same four steps that every guest takes on VRBO and booking.com. So if you're having a hard time with your clicks, for example, it's likely you're having the same problem on other platforms. So this platform can still be very helpful in optimizing your listing on all the other OTAs, even though you're only seeing your data on Airbnb. So what I want to do next is show you some context on what an impression actually is on Airbnb so that you know how to optimize your listing. We like to think of optimizing your listing into three basic steps. The first step is isolate your issue, meaning which of these four steps are you having trouble with? So let's go through the four steps very quickly to help you understand what each of these actually mean. 90% of guests, when they book an Airbnb, don't Google the Airbnb they're looking for. They actually go to Airbnb.com. Then once they go to Airbnb.com, they use these filters to select their destination, they select their check-in days, and they select their number of guests. Now, once they do that, they come up with this screen. An impression is anyone that appeared in this search, whether they appeared on page 1 or page 15. To be clear, it does not mean somebody actually saw your listing. It just means that you appeared in search somewhere. This is the first step to getting booked on Airbnb, because you've got to get in that search, and the name of the game is filters. You need to appear in as many filters as possible, like date filters, location filters, and pricing filters. The second step is getting on page 1. Most people do not leave page 1. So this is what we call a first page impression. Everyone that just got on page 1 got recorded for a first page impression. Now, notice what happens if I scroll in on this map. I get a whole different set of results. Everyone that just got on this next page also got an impression, and the people that got on this first page got a first page impression as well. So we just covered the first two steps, an impression and a first page impression. The next step is getting clicked. You'll see that on this first page, there's only certain things that a guest can actually see to determine which property to click on. Obviously, the biggest piece of real estate is your cover photo, followed by what type of home it is and location, your number of reviews and your quality of reviews, your title, your number of beds, and then your price. So if you're having a click problem, it's likely due to one of those issues. Now the final step is after somebody has actually clicked on your property, you need to convince them to book. This is what we call conversion or nights booked in your IntelliHost dashboard. So if you're having a conversion issue, it's because someone is getting to this page, but they're not checking out for some reason. The reason it's important to understand these four steps is because once you've isolated your issue, IntelliHost will make it very clear and easy to understand which step you're having a problem with. Then you need to experience that step as a guest. So if in this example, this property is having a click problem, meaning it's not getting as many clicks and it's not converting into clicks as efficiently as its competition. So what I need to do is go back a step and look at this page to understand why someone is more likely to click on my competition than they are to click on me. Now in this case, this property is using a logo, which may be the reason, but it also may be the price, it could be reviews and other things. Step two of optimizing your listing, experience that step as a guest. Now if I'm having a conversion issue, then I would actually click on my listing and see why people might not be checking out. What you'll notice is IntelliHost offers a list of recommendations for each step. So if you don't know what might be impacting or you need some ideas on what could potentially be wrong with that step, you can always click on see recommendations to get a list of things that our algorithm will evaluate your property on and tell you what you need to do to improve that step. Recommendations is not part of the free trial, but it is available via subscription. So the third step of the optimization process, now that we've identified the issue, we've experienced the problem as a guest and identified what issues might be the problem, this third step is actually making the changes that will optimize your listing. What we've done is provided what we call the change tracker. This is also known as the A/B tester. Now, the change tracker automatically pulls in any changes you've made and summarizes the impact of those changes for you. You don't need to manually go in here and log anything. Now, we're going to pull a lot of different metrics that we identify on a daily basis. Things like your photos, your description, your title, all of those things are being automatically detected. The only things that are not automatically detected are things like your minimum night stay and your pricing. Those are highly dynamic and very difficult to track. So once you come to the change tracker, you can open up the dropdown and see the three changes that I made on 7/20. You can see that I removed these photos, I changed the photo order here, and I added a new photo, this cover here. I was trying to improve my click rate. So I want to pay special attention to the click rate metric. Now, if I hover over any of these metrics, I can actually see how that rate changed over time. You'll notice that we're actually tracking the rate. And the reason we track rate is because the click volume is highly dependent on seasonality. So you can have a lot more clicks in one season over another, and it might not have anything to do with your change. But click rate, on the other hand, is taking your number of clicks divided by your first page impressions, therefore normalizing for that seasonality so you can identify what's actually driving change. You can see in this example, changing these photos actually increased my click rate on average about 11%, which is really great. We're also doing a little bit of a forecast in the dollar impact here. And the way we calculate that is by taking your last 52 weeks of revenue and applying this percentage change going forward, basically estimating what kind of dollar impact that would have for you. So that's how the change tracker works. You can use this, like I said, to make lots of changes, and we recommend that you space out your changes within at least a week of each other. The reason for that is because we cannot isolate the difference that one change is making from another. So if you want to be really scientific and clear about which changes are making the biggest difference, we do recommend you space them out by about a week. The final tool I want to show you is the price tweaker tool. The price tweaker tool tends to be used the most by our super users and the people that are optimizing their properties on a daily basis. And the way you use price tweaker is by coming in here and comparing your property to your competition's traffic for future days. What we're looking at here is the next 90 days on our calendar. We can see that how many clicks, you can see we're toggled on clicks right now, how many clicks we're getting compared to our competition. You can see that on the date of September 2nd, we've only gotten one click. And if we want to get booked, it seems like we're going to have to do something because our competition has gotten 11 clicks for the same day. Now, if I want to go up the booking funnel a little bit, I can unclick the clicks and click first page impressions. Now, this is interesting because I can see that I'm actually getting about the same number of first page impressions as my competition for that specific specific day. So what that tells me is I'm not converting people from first page impressions to clicks on that specific day very well. And if I want to do so, I'm probably gonna have to reduce my price a little bit to actually get booked there. You can use Price Tweaker to make sure you're not leaving any money on the table. You can make sure you get your days booked, but you're also not underpriced. Because if I see my data flying way above my competition on a given day, it might mean I'm underpriced and I can actually increase my pricing so that I'm not leaving that money on the table on my calendar. So that's IntelliHost in a nutshell. And the good news is we're a little bit crazy. So we're giving you 30 days free, no obligation. So you can actually sign up for a free 30-day trial, check out and see if it's something that you like, you value, and no credit card required. There's really no risk to you. And if you still have questions, feel free to schedule a call with one of our support reps and we'll make sure we get those questions answered. See you inside.